Good morning, Carl.
Good morning.
It's 10 a.m. The weather is partly cloudy, 54 degrees, 80% humidity with a strong possibility of afternoon showers.
It sounds like a good day to spend in bed.
I did go to pick up the paint that you ordered.
Oh, yes, I've forgotten. That is the difference between you and me, right, Marcus? You never forget anything.
Show me your arm, please, Carl.
No.
Carl. Thank you.
I just opened my eyes and I'm already gritting my teeth. Humans are such a fragile machine. They break down so quickly. All this effort to keep them going. Hey, what happened to your clothes?
Oh, it's nothing. Just some demonstrators in the street, Carl.
What a bunch of idiots. They think they can stop progress by roughing up a few androids? I hope they didn't harm you.
Oh, no, no. They just pushed me around, Carl. I'm fine. Okay. I'll take you to the bathroom now. Oh.
Anything special on the agenda today?
Yes, there's the opening of your retrospective at the Museum of Modern Art. Mm. The gallery director left 4 messages asking to confirm your attendance.
I haven't decided yet. We'll see about that later.
Okay.
What else?
Just your usual fan mail. I've already answered.
Any news from Leo?
No, Carl. I can call him if you like.
No. No, don't bother. Television.
Tensions continue to rise in Moscow since Russia unilaterally declared the region part of its national territory. Russian warships have taken position in the Barents Sea since Saturday, and a Russian flag now flies over the ice. The Russian president.
Why don't you find something to do while I finish my breakfast?
Sure. Okay, Carl.
Television off. Mankind is so depressing. Nothing but greed, stupidity, and violence. 5,000 years of civilization just to get to where we are. Fancy game of chess?
Sure, yeah.
Speed chess.
Speed chess it is.
That was just a little bit too easy. Are your circuits rusty, or are you just taking pity on an old man?
Neither. Carl, you just played better.
Never throw a match, Marcus. If you can win, win. That's what got humanity where it is today. One day I won't be here to take care of you anymore. You'll have to protect yourself. And make your choices. Decide who you are and want to become. This world doesn't like those who are different, Marcus. Don't let anyone tell you who you should be. Let's go to the studio. Let's see where we left off. Remove the sheet. So, what's your verdict, Marcus?
Yes, there is something about it. Something I can't quite define. I guess I like it.
The truth is, I have nothing left to say anymore. Each day that goes by brings me closer to the end. I'm just an old man clinging to his brushes.
Carl.
But enough about me. Let's see if you have any talent. Give it a try. Try painting something.
Paint? What would I... Painting what?
Anything you want. Give it a try. That is a perfect copy of reality. The painting is not about replicating the world. It's about interpreting, improving on it, showing something you see.
Carl, I don't think I can do that. It's not in my program.
Go on, go, try it. Grab that canvas. Do something for me. Close your eyes. Close your eyes. Trust me. Try to imagine something that doesn't exist, something you've never seen. Now concentrate on how it makes you feel and let your hand drift across the canvas.
Hey, Dad.
Leo. I didn't hear you come in.
Oh, I was in the neighborhood. I thought I'd stop by. It's been a while, right?
You all right? You don't look so good.
Oh, yeah, I'm fine. Hey, listen, I need some cash, Dad.
Again? What happened to the money I just gave you?
It just goes, you know?
Yeah. Yeah, you're on it again, aren't you?
No, No, I swear, it's not that.
No, don't lie to me, Leo.
What difference does it make? I just need some cash, that's all.
Sorry. The answer's no.
What? Why?
You know why.
Yeah, I think I do know why. You'd rather take care of your plastic toy here than your own son, right? Tell me, Dad, what's it got that I don't? Smarter? More obedient? Not like me, right? But you know what? This thing is not your son. It's a fucking machine!
Leo, that's enough. Enough.
You don't care about anything except yourself and your goddamn paintings. You've never loved anyone. You never loved me, Dad. You never loved me.
Name's Carlos Ortiz. He has a record for theft and aggravated assault. According to the neighbors, he was kind of a loner. Stayed inside most of the time. They hardly ever saw him.
State he's in. Wasn't worth calling everybody out in the middle of the night. Could have waited till morning.
I'd say he's been there for a good 3 weeks. We'll know more when the coroner gets here. There's a kitchen knife over here. Probably the murder weapon.
Any sign of a break-in?
Nope. The landlord said the front door was locked from the inside. All the windows were boarded up. The killer must have gone out the back way.
What do we know about his android?
Not much. The neighbors confirmed he had one, but it wasn't here when we arrived. I gotta get some air. Make yourself at home, I think. I'll be outside if you need me.
Jesus, what the hell are you doing?
I'm analyzing the blood. I can check samples in real time. I'm sorry. I should have warned you.
Okay, just don't put any more evidence in your mouth. You got it?
Got it.
Fucking hell, I can't believe this shit.
Stabbed 28 times.
Yeah. Seems like the killer really had it in for him.
Lieutenant, I think I figured out what happened.
Oh, yeah? Shoot, I'm all ears.
It all started in the kitchen.
There are obvious signs of a struggle. Question is, what exactly happened here?
I think the victim attacked the android with the bat.
That lines up with the evidence. Go on.
The android stabbed the victim.
So the android was trying to defend itself, right? Okay, then what happened?
The victim fled to the living room.
To get away from the android. All right, that makes sense.
The android murdered the victim with the knife.
Okay. Your theory's not totally ridiculous, but it doesn't tell us where the android went.
It was damaged by the bat and lost some therium.
Lost some what?
Therium. You call it blue blood. It's the fluid that powers Android's biocomponents. It evaporates after a few hours and becomes invisible to the naked eye.
Oh, but I bet you can still see it, can't you?
Correct.
Yeah. What are you doing with that chair?
I'm going to check something.
Check something.
I was just defending myself. He was gonna kill me. I'm begging you. Don't tell him.
Connor, what the fuck is going on up there?
It's here, Lieutenant!
Oh, shit. Chris! Ben! Get your asses in here now!
Dinner is ready.
Yeah, I'm coming.
There wasn't much in the kitchen. I did what I could.
life's funny. I lost my job because of androids. Then when I need somebody to take care of this goddamn house, what do? I go out and hire a fucking android. What a joke. Of course, androids are so fucking wonderful. They never fail. They're never tired. Never sad. They're so fucking perfect, they ruin my fucking life! What are you looking at? What's your fucking problem? Not the life you dreamed of, eh? Maybe you think this is easy. Maybe you think it's my fault we live in this fucking shithole. My fault your fucking mother took off. You should stop taking drugs, Todd. Sometimes you really scare me, Todd. Fucking bitch took off without a word. Fucking whore walked out on me for a fucking accountant. It's all your fault.
Daddy, no.
It's all your fucking fault. Here. Come back here. Come back here right now. Yes! You stay there. Don't you dare fucking move, or I'll bust you worse than last time. Oh, took off without a word. Get the fuck out of here. That's an order!
No! I want you to leave her alone.
You want? What do you mean you want? What are you gonna do? You gonna shoot me? Is that it? You gonna shoot a human? You seem to have a problem. I think we need to fix that.
That was by far the most boring party I've been to in the last 25 years. Every time I go to one of these, I ask myself, what the hell am I doing here? I hate cocktail parties and all the schmoozers that go there.
Well, it's a chance for all those people who admire your work to meet you.
Yeah. No one gives a damn about art. All they care about is how much money they're gonna make out of it.
Scotch, neat as usual?
Absolutely.
Okay, but you know what your doctor would say.
Yeah, well, he can kiss my ass. I'm old enough to choose my own medication. Did you leave the light on in the studio?
No, I'm sure I didn't.
Call the police.
Detroit Police, what's your emergency?
This is Carl Manfred's android at 8941 Lafayette Avenue. We've just returned home and found the lights on. There may have been a break-in.
A patrol car is on the way.
Let's go check it out. Leo! What are you doing?
You refuse to help me, so I'm helping myself. It's crazy what some people pay for this shit.
Don't touch them.
Look, they're all gonna be mine sooner or later anyway. Just think of it as a down payment on my inheritance.
Marcus, get him away from there. Get him out of here.
Be reasonable. This isn't gonna get you anywhere.
All you ever do is tell me to go away. What's wrong, Dad? Not good enough for you? Not perfect, like this fucking thing?
That's enough! Get out! Right now!
What makes it so special anyway, huh? What's it got that I don't...
Leave him alone!
Come on! Let's see what you got!
Marcus, don't defend yourself, you hear me? Don't do anything.
Go ahead, hit me. What you waiting for? Think you're a man? Act like one!
Stop it!
Does it matter too much of a pussy?
Stop it, Leo! Stop it!
Just scared to fight back, you fucking bitch! Stop! Forgot you're not a real person, you're just a fucking piece of plastic!
No, Leo, leave him alone!
No. I'm gonna destroy you, and it'll just be me and my dad. I'm gonna tear you apart, and nobody's gonna give a shit. You know why? Because you're nothing. You hear me? You're nothing!
Carl, no! Carl.
Humans. Fragile machines.
Carl, don't leave, okay? Please don't go. Don't leave.
Remember, Marcus. Don't let anybody tell you who you are.
No. No. Dad. No. Please.
This is all your fault. This never would have happened if it weren't for you.
Over here.
The android. Who's the android?